What a great place to be. It's good to be here, Morse Farm.
Thank you.
And we've got Tom Morse here, filling in for the ever fantastic Burr Morse.
That's right.
You know, we're here talking maple, and it's really iconic in Vermont. But it's become something that is not just iconic. It's really been an essential tool that's helped a lot of our farmers diversify and hang in what is a very tough agricultural environment. Maple sugaring has used technology to become more efficient, to increase the output. And Vermonters have, with their Maple Sugar Association, done a very good job on marketing. And the Vermont brand is really unique for the best quality. We're here today because the Food and Drug Administration is on the verge of potentially passing a requirement in food labeling that would be extremely threatening to Vermont maple. What they're proposing to do is require in the nutrition label that there be a statement saying added sugars. There are no added sugars. Maple is a pure product. And added sugars to the consumer connotes corn syrup or some other added elements that are not natural. And a lot of consumers don't want added sugar. They want pure products, nothing more so than maple syrup. So why in the world is the FDA proposing to require a label that actually misleads rather than informs? And that's one question. But the second reality is that that would be very detrimental to the identity of this product. It's really essential to Morse Farm, and it's really essential to so many maple sugar farmers here in the state of Vermont. Senator Leahy and Senator Sanders and I are going to push back hard on what we think is a gross mistake by the Food and Drug Administration, where they're mislabeling. In the name of labeling and giving information, they're giving misinformation. There are no added sugars in pure Vermont maple syrup. All there is in pure Vermont maple syrup is pure tasting pleasure. So we'll get to that in a little bit. But I want to thank everybody for what they've done. And I want to now turn it over to the senior senator from the state of Vermont, a longtime maple syrup connoisseur, and Senator Leahy.
And there's only one guy, and that's Vermont. Peter, thank you for putting this together. And Roger, thank you for coming to the office the other day, and Ms. Marvin and others who did. Here's the, I don't know if you can see this, but here's the two labels we're talking about for the same thing. And calories remain the same and all of that. But the label on the left says, you know, the calories and so on. But then the label on the right says it's 17% added sugar. There is no added sugar in pure maple syrup, just like there isn't in pure honey. I use an example of this. A good friend of ours, going through a lot of illnesses, chemo and so on, and Marcella spent a lot of time with her, and she was told she couldn't have sugar in her coffee, she couldn't have sugar in some things because it's processed, and the doctors didn't want it, but they said the one thing you can have is pure maple syrup. Well, in our home in Vermont, our home in Washington, there's plenty of that. Marcel delivered it the next day. So I asked the commissioner to come in and see me. And we had a long talk with him. We brought in the experts from my Agriculture Committee and Appropriations Committee and talked to him and said, you know, this is a mistake. And he's well aware of pure maple syrup. And Vassar make a change. I also touched a few things in the Appropriations Committee. Now, in the last Farm Bill, it was helpful to work on this because Peter would handle it on the House side and what we were bringing to conference. I would on the Senate side, and we were able to accomplish something. But I've added this. I put in language that requires the FDA to report to the committee on its efforts to address consumer confusion. That's what I told the commissioner. You're going to have to respond to what this is. It's the easiest way, of course, to say no added sugar. I required them to analyze the nutrient value of maple syrup and can it be exempted. I also put in $3 million for the ESER Maple Grant Program, which is a $2 million increase. UVM Proctor Research got another $350,000. I'm trying to make it clear to them this is not just a passing thing. I was born just a couple miles from here. I know how much work goes into the maple industry. I went with my grandparents in South Reigate. I went other places and see this. This is an industry that we want to keep in Vermont. We want the Vermont label to mean something. Pure Vermont maple syrup. Otherwise, you know what you're going to have. If they just make this all the same, you're going to have this cockamamie kind of corn syrup with probably a picture of a Vermont maple shed on it. There's no maple in it. It is all sugar. And that's, we showed the commissioner the difference between a bottle of real maple syrup and our. I would have offered to give it to him. I didn't want to think it's being bribed. And it is going to make it go. But this will hurt this industry. All three of us are going to fight like mad. Peter's fighting in the House. I'm fighting both the Appropriations Committee and the Agriculture Committee with the legislation we're going to have in both committees. So thank you for doing this, Tom. And
our pleasure.
I feel at home here. As you know, I've been here so many times that when the kids and grandkids are in town, they love coming here.
Tom, put him to work.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Tom Morris, our host.
Thank you very much.
Sure, Tom, get over here to the microphone.
Pleasure to have you all here, and the Congressman Matt Gordon from our state association here with us. And boy, what a great thing to have these two guys working on our behalf in Washington. And Matt's doing so much great work with the marketing of our state product here. And like Patrick's saying, that's just the wrong approach for the federal government to be taken. We don't need that. We need positive marketing. It's a pure natural product. It comes right from the trees, right from the soil around here. We just refine it and we market it, and we keep the quality as high as we possibly can. It's 67% maple sugar, and that's what it is. Nothing more, nothing less. We're very happy to be a part of this this new marketing that the state of Vermont, our association, is doing, sending syrup all over the country, all over the world. Vermont has such a good name when it comes to premium maple syrup, and we like to think it's the best. I don't want to knock other states or Canada. It is the best. We've got that premium reputation, and we're proud of it. We're not all factory operations like they are in Quebec and Ontario. Our government kind of stays out of it. We kind of regulate things as far as the how much we make. There's no quotas, and we're all just very proud of what we do, and very proud to have these gentlemen working on our behalf. So thank you guys.
Thanks, Tom. Thank you, Tom. Appreciate it. Our next speaker is Roger Brown from Slopeside Maple. Roger, thank you.
Well, thank you both for speaking up on this issue. Like we've insinuated, there is some disagreement over what maple syrup is best between the U.S. and Canada and each of the states. But one thing the maple industry has really come together with is that this makes no sense, which seems like a pretty easy thing to agree on. It's clear that when applied to broadly, this is an example of well-intentioned federal regulation that is totally illogical when applied in this context. This is something that if the federal government can't figure out that this makes no sense, it doesn't give you much hope for the ability of us to solve any problems. It's obvious. It's obvious. Why would you put added sugar on a bottle of maple syrup? It's not gonna help move anybody forward. It's not gonna let consumers know that they're eating sugar. I mean, it's a bottle of syrup that they're putting on their pancakes. They know what they're doing, and it's really gonna hurt the maple industry in a way that's unnecessary and illogical. So thanks again to you both for fighting for the maple industry. I think it's a long history of Vermont's representatives doing that, and that's why we have such a great product.
Thanks, Roger.
Thank you.
Matt Gordon, the Executive Director of the Vermont Maple Sugar Producers Association.
Thank you, and thank you both for all the work that you've done on our behalf in the industry. We greatly appreciate it. There's a sense of irony here that 125 years ago, in 1893, the Vermont Maple Sugar Makers Association was formed chiefly to protect against adulterated maple syrup, where people were adding sugar to syrup and selling it or using the Vermont brand illegally and selling non-maple syrup as pure maple syrup, pure Vermont maple syrup. And here we are today, sort of fighting federal regulations that are making it look like we are adding sugar to our product when we're in fact not adding anything at all. So there is there's definitely a bit of irony and a bit of what's old is new again as well. And a 2015 study found that the Vermont maple industry, so sugar makers, processors, equipment manufacturers, and dealers, contributed about $350 million to the Vermont economy. In that time, our industry has grown even further. We've produced more syrup. There are more people tapping trees, both more taps set out in the year. So I suspect that number has increased, and the maple industry is bringing jobs to parts of the Vermont where a little underserved, where jobs can be a little scarce, and at a time of year when other trades are slow in the springtime. So anything right now that could slow down the growth that we are seeing in our industry could be very detrimental to maple producers. So I really do appreciate the work you guys are doing on our behalf to help push back against this. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Matt. And our last speaker, Erica Campbell, is here on behalf of Senator Sanders. And I just have a question for Bernie. Wherever you are, this is a better place to be.
You sure you're a little bit
better? I will. Well, I am so sorry that Senator Sanders is not here today. The maple industry is so important to our state, not just in those big hundreds of millions of dollars in direct impact, but all of the indirect and tangible impacts that are so hard to measure, really about our quality of life here. This is really unfortunate. I think this whole added sugar thing, we know that Americans have issues with sugar, and we need more consumer education and proper labeling around sugars in our diets. This is an obvious unintended consequence that we did not want to see. And so, Senator Sanders is on the HELP committee that oversees FDA, and we're not sure where this will go there. We're really grateful that Senator Leahy and Congressman Welch are really taking a hard look at this, because from all indications that we can see, from the HELP committee, we don't know where this will go. To be honest, we're not sure if this issue will, these rules will be really opened up. Any movement we can make through the Farm Bill and other areas, I think will be critical to making sure that, we don't have this. The maple industry has fought so hard for the purity of their product. And, whether it's taking on the corn industry giants or out-of-state maple producers capitalizing on Vermont's good name. So just want to say thank you for all the work, and thank you to the maple producers for doing incredible work all the time. So thanks everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think it's time for our tasting test. It's the moment we came for, and then we can take a few questions. But Matt, you wanna pass out samples? Right now, we're all Homer Simpson. This is what Homer had for breakfast.
Hi. As Marcel will tell you, I put it on English muffins in the morning.
Well, it's good
everywhere. And vanilla ice cream.
All right, here's the Vermont Pure Maple Syrup. All right?
Cheers.
Cheers. Mm. This is good. Thank you. That is so delicious. That is good. Any questions?
What is the motivation here? What do you think is going on?
Oh, no, well, I think the FDA is correct, and you mentioned it too, that with the concerns, obesity, diabetes, and all, you should have some indication. But this is like saying, putting a label on a boat and saying, use this in water, not on the highway. I mean, you say this is, it's not added sugar. Maple syrup is maple syrup. And what in my meetings with the commissioner, and with the addendum I put in the appropriations bill, I'm trying to get their attention. I don't mind them having sugar labeling for things where you add sugar. But honey, maple syrup, come on. That's like saying, this red paint is red.
And they proposed a change, right? To put a little symbol next to...
Well, that's what we're hearing a bit. Right. In the House, I'm working with Kevin Kramer, who's a Republican member of Congress from North Dakota, and we're writing to the FDA commissioner, urging him to take that out. But what you're seeing with that, the added sugars really makes no sense. You can't justify it. And the fact that they're coming back to us is an indication of some movement. You know, my experience
with these labels.
Yeah.
Sure. Calories have not changed at all in this thing, but it gets very, very confusing with the added sugar.
Right. You know, the FDA, it's a very important agency to help protect health, but they get labeling wrong a lot of times. Added sugars, there are no added sugars. We had a real problem with the FDA when it came to cheese. They were going to ban cheese boards. Because one facility was wrong, and that would have put a lot of our folks out of business. They were going to deny the opportunity for our beer makers to use their spent grain and give it to local farmers. So they get it wrong, they overdo it, and it takes pushback, in this case from the maple producership makers, from the beer makers, from the cheese makers, to just get it right. Nobody is more interested in having pure Vermont maple syrup and its reputation maintained than the maple syrup producers. That's their livelihood. So the FDA's got to get it right, not get it wrong.
I just wish some of the people that actually write these regulations, Peter mentioned the cheese boards or this, would spend a couple days watching make maple syrup. Spend a couple days. Places like Hardwick, where especially cheeses are being made, spend some time and see what is involved. You know, they spend too much time looking at prepackaged, factory produced stuff that is not like you have here.
Do you know when the final rule's coming out? The FDA said this spring.
Well, I think it may be delayed a bit after our meeting, we hope, after the meeting we had with the commissioner. And we're following up actually this week, and both our offices are.
And by the way, there is bipartisan support for this. I mean, whether you're a maple sugar producer in Vermont or Michigan, this is going to have an impact. And of course, it has the same impact on honey. So Kevin Kramer, they have a, in North Dakota, they have a big honey production issue, and they'd be adversely affected as well. So that's actually going to, I think, strengthen our hand. And it's also the case that the maple producers are like, you know, they're like real wonderful people. we can't be making your life hard, your hard life harder. Right.
We're talking Marjorie. Yeah. Well, but the thing is, you know what's interesting? When I raised this in the Appropriations Committee, they never thought of it. Most of the members, a couple have, they're from this part of the country. But the others, oh, yeah, that makes sense. And they understood it very, very quickly. Anyway, all right.
Thank you. There might be some extra maple syrup here for you guys. I'd grab some.
It's really good.